What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the brand new Android app development tutorial, and this is the series 3 where we are going to take a look at how to program an Android app. So in this case, I'm gonna open the Android Studio. So yeah, we have the dark Dracula background for the Android Studio from the last tutorial. So what I'm gonna do is changing the background into white again. So going to the configure, selecting the settings. Now going to the appearance, and from here I'm gonna go with the IntelliJ, clicking the apply, and there you go. Okay, so let's continue to our Android app project. So everything is done really faster because we are using this continuously again. Okay, anyway, today what we are going to do is that, so first of all, before that I want to say that we have a text view inside this app. We have a button, so I'm gonna go and use this button in this tutorial, and I want to remove this text view, so I'm gonna delete that one. Okay, so now we can see we have a layout file with a button, and looking to the button we can see here is a text that is click me. We used a string resource. Now at the top you can see here is a button ID, that's the Android colon ID equal to at plus ID slash button. So what we are going to do is that we have to add an action when the button or the user press this button. We have to add an action. So action can be anything like changing the button text, or changing the button color or background color, or even we can use external item as a result. So like that, when the user click that, we can also give a pop-up message saying that yay, you click the button. So likewise, we can do anything by a simple button click. So all you have to do is you have to just remember the name or the ID of this button. So in this case we have the ID as button. Let's go to the MainActivity.java. You can find the same file, as I said, you can find it by the going to the main root folder, that is app, and inside that we can see the Java, and go to the first folder inside the Java, and here is the MainActivity.java. Okay, anyway, we have discussed about the main activity and the structure of this main activity and the Java files in the first tutorial. So anyway, once again I'm repeating, here is the package name that you have given at the first or at the beginning, and here is the import and public class, and inside the two braces open and close we have the one create method added here. So first of all, here is the package name and everything is here. And now let's go, and before adding a button we have to be familiar with this code. So we have used a one override protected void one create method, and so this method insert some of the main elements required for your Android app. So when you're looking to this course, you can see here is a method which we can easily identify what the use of this. So here it is, set content view, and in the bracket you can see that is our dot layout dot activity main. So set the content view is a method that use it to set the layout of the Android app, or as corresponding to this class file. So likewise, as the Java is a high level language, as the high level languages are similar to the English words, it is easy for us to identify each code. So anyway, what we have to do is that we're gonna be adding a button, as I said. So we have the ID for the button as button again, and we are going to the main activity and introducing the button here. So under the public class main activity extend app compact activity, then braces, under that we have to add a line that is button. Okay, now you can see when I type button, you can see here it shows in red color, which represent that there is the error, and the error is that cannot resolve symbol button. So that means Java class cannot identify the user typed value or user typed character. So that means all we have to do is that when we are inserting a widget into the Java class, all we have to do is just type it like a uppercase letter at the first. Let me type by button. So when I type button, you can see here is a pop-up. It shows that do you want to import the button as a widget into this category. So likewise, that's all you have to do is just double click on the button. Now you can see it's added a one more line, import android.widget.button, then semicolon. So let me remove that one thing. Okay, now again I'm typing button. So if you haven't seen this pop-up, you can also, if you're only getting a similar, that you only return that but you doesn't get a pop-up, then all you have to do is just keep your mouse over the character, just give a one mouse button left click, then you will be getting a pop-up like this. If you haven't get, no problem, just press Alt Enter, just like how you have extracted the string in the activity main.xml in our series 2. Likewise, when you press Alt Enter, you can also import the same button through the pop-up. So finally, we have added a button, but what happened if the user has more than one button? Let's see. Okay, I'm gonna copy the same. Now changing the button into button 2, button 3. Okay, now as you can see, I have 3 buttons in my activity, and I want to add each click listener for each of these buttons. So Java can't identify which the button we are intending to add a click, or what we are going to do with that particular button. So all we have to do is we have to give name for each buttons. So likewise, in case of Java programming or many other languages, we call the name as variables. So the variables are a particular type of characters that represent each buttons. So likewise, let me show you an example. So this is the first, we have introduced the button into this Java class, and now we have to insert a variable or name for each button. So let me go with the BT. So I represent the button as BT. So let's suppose I only have a single button. Now I have added a BT. Let's add a BT1. Okay, now it's BT1. Now if you want to add the second button, all you have to do is just copy this, again paste it here, and change the BT1 to BT2. So now you can see, if I have 100 buttons, I should keep doing this all the lines, but it is rotating. That doesn't make any sense of writing an Android app. Instead of making an Android app, you can do it manually. So our goal is to make everything simplified. So for that, you have to simply add, if you have multiple button, you have to simply add a comma one after one variable, then again give it a space or not. For a beauty, I'm giving it a space. Again, I'm typing the BT2, again giving the comma, again giving it space, and typing the third one, BT3. Now you can see there is no error up to this, but the final you can see here is a small error that is expected, a semicolon. So Java is, as I said before, the Java is much very easy to learn. So you will be reminded about the mistake that you have done in the program. So likewise, here it is expected a semicolon. So why not, we can give a semicolon. Let's add a semicolon. Now as you can see, there is no any kind of errors, and even the mainactivity.java have no any kind of errors. When I remove the semicolon, you can see here it shows a red underline, that means that represent the error. Again, I'm adding it. Now there is no errors. So likewise, we can add more and more button into this. So I'm gonna go with this button 1 and removing all the other buttons. Now likewise, I'm removing all other buttons from the layout. Now we only have a button, so the ID of the button is button itself. Let me go back to the mainactivity.java. Now we have to add a listener for the button. So when the user press the button, we have to give a certain activity or action for the button click. So like that, likewise, all you have to do is under the set content view, we have to give some other lines. So the first line is to be introduce the button inside this one create method. So all you have to do is just type BT1, so that is the variable name of the first button. So BT1 equal to, what is that, what is BT1? So what you have written is only up to here. Well, the one create method doesn't know what you have written above. We have to teach the one create method what we have given at the top. So likewise, we have to add BT1 equal to, and inside the bracket you have to type button. So you have to add the variables and the main head for the variables inside the bracket. So once you have add a button inside the bracket, all you have to do is just type for find view by ID. So you don't have to type fully, but just pressing enter, that will be auto completer. Now you can see shows that at ID rests in the ID. So in this case, it says that you have to mention the ID for this variable. So we have the first variable BD, and in the activity main we can see here is a button, that's the ID name of this button. So likewise, we're gonna be adding the ID or introducing the ID into this one create method. So r.id.button. So now we have done, finally it again expected a semicolon, so all we had to do is just add it. Okay, now there is no errors. So now the onCreate method know what is BD1. So finally we have teacher the onCreate method that BD1 is a button. So again, finally we have to add BT1 again. Then now in this time we have to add a dot, then set one click listener. So when I type set one click listener, you can see in the pop-up, you can see that one click listener is already shown. Let's click on that. I just double clicked on the first result from the pop-up. Now you can see it again expected something inside this bracket. So all we have to do is just type new, because this guy is a new anyway, one click listener. So when I type new one click listener, you can simply double click on the first results shown on the pop-up. Okay, double click. Now as you can see, when I double click on the one click listener, all these lines are already written by the Android Studio. So that make really more easier to type each codes. So even at this point, I didn't get any kind of errors that you can easily identify if there is any kind of errors by looking into the MainActivity.java, whether it has a underline or not. Anyway, we have the public void one click view.view and blah blah blah, many other things. So all you had to do is, if you want to give an action for this button, all you had to do is just add the action under the public void one click method. So in case of button and many other things, we have to use one click method to show or give an action for the button. So in my case, we have the button BD1. Okay, so BD1 is the variable name that we have given for the button. So BD1 dot, so what we had to do, so in this case we have many options that we can follow up. So let's suppose we want to show a pop-up message when the BD1 is clicked. So again, I'm reminding the BD1 is this button. So when the user is in the app, when the user press this button, we have to add a certain message to be popped up when the user press this again. Okay, so all we have to do is, in Android app development, we have a method that is toast, which shows the pop-up message for the users. So I'm gonna go with the pop-up message. I want to show pop-up message when the user click this button. So all you have to do is simply, we have to type for toast, that the pop-up is known by the name toast in the Java programming. When I type a toast, you can see also it's imported the Android widget toast. So toast is a part of widget in the Android. Okay, anyway, so all we have to do is just type toast. So toast.makeText, then again get application context, then comma, then your text here, again add comma. Now we have to give the toast length, duration, or whatever else you want to call it. Okay, now you can see how I added the style of the toast and the method, and here is the pop-up message, and we have also introduced the time duration for the toast, and finally we have added dot show. So if we forget to add the dot show and we just completed the toast by a semicolon, the toast is not going to work in an Android app. So we have to finally add dot show, and we have to stop with the semicolon. So at this time we have seen there is no any other kind of errors. We have done with this. So the final step is that we're gonna run this app in a live device and check that out.
So in order to run your app on a live device, you have to connect your Android device through the USB cable and make sure that you have installed the USB drivers corresponding to your Android device. So once you have connected, you have to go to the run, which you can see here is a green button, or you can go to the run from here and run the app, and you can also use the shortcut shift plus F10. So I want to click on this button. Now you can see here we have the option to select the deployment target. So I have connected my personal phone to the USB cable, and you can see here it is connected. So now I want to select this one, clicking on the use same selection for future launches, because I want to use the same device when I want to launch in the future, so that you can avoid getting the same window. So finally you have to select your device and click on the OK, and there you go. Once the build is complete, you can see your Android app will be running on your live device.
Oh yeah, you can see when I press the button, the message is shown. That's the pop-up is shown by a toss. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this tutorial. If you want to go more professional, you can subscribe to my channel and continue watching the upcoming series. So if you end up with any kind of errors, you can probably comment below and I will be showing you the right solution for that. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in my next tutorial.